joining us for the first time. This is Mesh Story, and the theme for today is the 24-hour streamer. So it's the diary of the 24-hour streamer, and here's where our guests are going to give their take on the life of a 24-hour streamer. If they choose, they can add some fanciful backdrops, they can add some special accents, like from the French, or we can be a spot of tea. Whatever they like, however creative they like to be, they have full range. They're just not allowed to use, you know, expletive languages and words, but they are all encouraged to make sure that we're all having fun, and they're having fun as they're telling the story. At 4 o'clock, ladies and gentlemen, is when I will announce the gold king or queen for the stream. And that person is going to have a special IG shout out. And how do you get there? How do I become a gold king or queen? You just got to be that number one gifter at 4 o'clock sharp on the dot. So who has what it takes to be the gold king or queen? At 4 o'clock, we will find out. But ladies and gentlemen, you are here for the show. And another little side note, these stories are judged, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, they are judged. We have three fabulous top badges. Top Bad Smurfy, Top Bad Zoe XX, and also Top Badge Krabby, all from the UK, all my fabulous friends. And they are going to be looking for some special little things, and they'll get into it, some of the criteria that they look for in creating the show. Double M, please. So ladies and gentlemen, we are going to hear from our very first guest. I'm going to ask all of the storytellers to please request the box. Judges, are we ready? Can the judges put a one in the comments if they're ready, their notepads are out, and they're ready? Moody, please. I see my judges in here. All right, we're all set. All right, ladies and gentlemen, she is no stranger to our storytelling show. She's been on here and she's quite lovely, and she always has an interesting take, whatever the theme is. Ladies and gentlemen, please make sure you're not only favoriting her, but go give her a visit. She's known as the one and only Miss Tawny. Now, if she chooses, she can introduce herself and then jump into her tale. Tawny, thank you so much for doing this show again.
What's up, guys? I'm actually like hella nervous, but we're gonna do this. We're gonna have fun. Hi, guys. For those who don't know me, I'm the only Miss Tawny. I've been on the app for 4 years as a streamer. I stream mostly nights and evenings after work, or you know, before work if I get a chance. I'm on Lux's Tic-Tac-Toe Trivia Show tonight. I have a Halloween auction with Krabby, and I admin for Not Too Shabby. I have my own show on Wednesday, 7 Eastern, No Blues News, and sharing positive news and entertainment stories with guests. Okay. We have our people represented in my story, my little pin people for everybody in my story. All right. Our tale begins in the streets of Meet Me, a world of live streamers and doing featured shows, having battles, and Friday night box parties. This is the story of streamer girl Tawny. Okay, and my mission to embark on a 24-hour stream. As many other amazing top streamers have done, this Sunday, we plan music, comedy, games, and dancing, and streaming. Always, we know there's always unexpected moments in streaming. Crap. The LED lights are ready. The playlist is set. Okay. And DJ Boy is on deck, ready to perform. We've had plenty of friends visit. We're at the 4 hour point. And as DJ Boy joins the box for a set, we begin the wheel challenge portion of the stream as Boric Queen, Bosbro, and Mej join the box to show us their best dance moves. And as the 500 wheels spin, and we party with DJ Ya Boy, Bouncers, Andrew, and Vampy kick out the trolls to stop bullying our friends and to not ruin the night. 8 hours in the transition, and drinks and game night, we learn about our fellow streamers from Would You Rather. Yay, the halfway point is we enter the kitchen to grab some chips and queso and make some waffles for a nice breakfast as streamer girl Tawny secretly calls into work. Shh, don't tell. After some waffles and coffee, 14 hours in, streamer girl Tawny scrolls through her battles list. She begins with Blake, Premier, and Krabby as we have impromptu playlist and karaoke battles. While streamer girl Tawny tries to convince her friends to take shots, the mission works, but we gotta keep it classy on the meet me streets. Okay. The mission, okay, crap. 16 hours in, how about a little box party? Look, our news day set is, our new Jay's challenge, sorry, is sending pizza gifts to 20 streamers as we all complete our challenges in the story of the day time and chats about our future live fest plans. The rest of the stream continues as we head into chat and chill vibes. What's this? 22 hours in, Raj hits an ice dragon. Oh my God, let's go, Raj, yay! Okay, the night ends and streamer girl Tawny's 24 hour stream will go down in history.
Ladies and gentlemen, please make sure that you're hitting that star on Miss Tawny. Just click on her profile, hit her up with a favorite. Thank you so much for being a part of our show. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're now tuning in, you are listening to the only Miss Tawny give her take on the 24-hour streamer. She was reading from her diary.
And
thank you.
Shout out. Okay, we got Raj, we got Mej, we got Krabby, we got Boss Bro, we got, you know, we got
I think you did it the other way around. We can't make out any of it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're now tuning in, you are listening to stories being spun on today's theme of the 24-hour streamer. That's going to be readings from their diary. So what will the diary entail? But you need to stay tuned to find out. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Once Upon a Miss Story, a storytelling show here on the app every Saturday at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And this is where we give our guests a theme. And based on the theme, they create a whole narrative and they fill it up with some juicy, salacious drama most of the times, and they can add backdrops, they can add some fanciful accents, all to make it fun and entertaining for you. So I hope you're favoriting everyone, and please be kind in the comments or you will be removed. And ladies and gentlemen, this is a judge show. So in the end, our judges are going to box up. They'll give you some feedback because if you're not the winner of today's show, you're highly encouraged to return another time and, you know, maybe win this whole thing. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, may I introduce my next guest. He goes by the name of King Goober. He is going to first introduce himself, and then afterwards he is going to jump into his take on the theme, The Diary of a 24-Hour Streamer. Hi, King Goober.
Hey, how y'all doing? Hi, Mej. How are you? Don't mind me. I'm just nervous.
I know. Well, if you'd like to introduce yourself now or in the end, feel free to do so, and then you can jump right into your story.
Okay. I might be too petrified after the story to introduce myself, so I'll do it now. I'm King Goober. I try to stream every day, and the time varies, but at least like once in the evening, once in the morning. I did that reverse there. It's all about good love and vibes for me. I'm a goofball, hence the name. So I'll stop right there and start with the story. Otherwise, I'm going to ramble for the whole 5 minutes, and we don't want that. So, all right. Anyone else nervous? All right. So just a quick little intro, because I'm an anime nerd.
Hey,
All right. Hopefully that was short enough. All right. Welcome. I'd like to tell you a story about a new streamer by the name of Draven. You see, Draven may be new to streaming. However, he is not unfamiliar with it. Draven has many friends that are streamers and inspired him to start streaming. On Draven's first stream, he was live for over 12 hours. Granted, he didn't really do anything except for listen to music while dancing like an idiot, but 12 hours is a long time for a new streamer, and he knew that, which is exactly why he decided to challenge himself. He then started coming up with newer content, playing games inspired by real life card and board games, playing instruments, creating his own talk show, or just talking endlessly until he just loses his breath. Anyways, moving on. Draven became obsessed with creating as much content as possible to the point that he wasn't going to be satisfied until he had a plethora amount of different content. The reason for this is because Draven decided that he would no longer stream for less than 24 hours per stream. Oh, if y'all didn't know by now, yeah, Draven looked great, great. After Draven's second stream, which lasted exactly 24 hours, he realized that he was going to need a journal / diary to remind himself of what exactly he did every time he streamed. And that, everyone, is how I came into the picture. That's right. You guessed it. The narrator is the diary itself. How else did you think I knew everything? I'm not Draven. This ain't no third person. Once he got me, he started writing down everything that would happen in his stream. This would continue for a whole year before he started noticing some changes that were brought up by his fellow streaming friends. Now, to be clear, Draven never let up on the streaming. A year had passed by and Draven was streaming 48 to 72 hours per stream. You would think that this would get harder for him. However, this was the complete opposite for Draven. It became so easy for Draven that he didn't even notice he was getting addicted / obsessed to the stream. Like I said a little earlier, his streaming friends that originally inspired Draven to start streaming had to point it out. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough. Draven was so far down the rabbit hole, he would forget to eat. He would even forget to sleep a lot as well. Now, don't get me wrong, Draven was thriving in the streaming world. Another year had passed and Draven was among the top 1% and had gathered about 5,000 followers in the 2 years that he's been streaming. At this point, Draven had 4 shows. 3 of them were just your average game shows, which a lot of people enjoyed. 4th show was a talk show that covered a wide range of topics, such as mental health, daily struggles, and ironically enough, obsession and addiction. Now, streaming-wise, like I said, he was thriving. However, his real life was starting to fall apart. Draven was so consumed with streaming, he would miss out on a lot of events in his real life, such as birthdays, weddings, anniversaries, and even funerals. It's a good thing that he had already started getting paid because Draven ended up losing his real life job as well. 6 months later, Draven started getting sick. Because of the fact that Draven wasn't taking care of himself, he eventually had to check himself into the hospital. Oh, it got that bad. Draven still hadn't realized the damage that his obsession / addiction was causing on his life. He lost a lot of friends, family members, and also his free will. He got so sick that he had to live in the hospital and the hospital staff confiscated his streaming equipment. After realizing it wasn't helping him, but only making it worse. Ooh, I read that wrong, sorry. 2 weeks had gone by, Draven was slowly starting to get better. He was eating more and was starting to take better care of himself. Another 2 weeks later, he was able to go home. At this point in his life and for the time since he started streaming, Draven realized the severity of the damage his obsession / addiction had caused. It was at this moment, Draven had decided to make some changes. He no longer was streaming every day and stopped doing streams that would last over 24 hours. He finally got it. Now Draven still streams, but he no longer allows his streaming life to dictate how the rest of his life, real life goes. Draven finally found the perfect balance. That is the end. Mind you, context, I was really high when I wrote this and I was panicking. I'm sorry.
It is okay. Practice makes perfect. And it's all what the judges were looking for. I have no input on it. So maybe it struck a chord with the judges. In just a few, we will find out what they think of the story for today. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're now tuning in, you are listening to King Goober give his take on The Diary of a 24-hour streamer. Thank you so much for being on the show. If you wait right back in the audience, and in a bit, the judges will box up and give their feedback on today's, all of today's stories. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, are we ready for our next guest? Ladies and gentlemen, if you're now tuning in, welcome, welcome, welcome to Once Upon a Mess Story, a storytelling show here on the app. And it is where we give the guests a theme. And based on the theme, they create a narrative, a creative narrative that is all fun and for your enjoyment. So I hope everyone is enjoying the show. Please be supportive. It can be a little nerve-wracking, especially when you are the focus on a show, especially when it's featured. So I must thank all of my guests. I firsthand know how nerve-wracking can be being a part of a show. So let's be kind to our comments. Let's be encouraging. And definitely let's make sure we are favoriting all these brave, brave guests who are, you know, letting you into some of their creative juices as they're flowing. So please make sure we're being kind with our words. Ladies and gentlemen, that being said, I must welcome my next guest, who is a top badge on the streaming app. And a little side note, this top badge was also grinding for 24 hours for the battle games. But man, giving too much. But he is going to box up and he's going to give his account of the diary of a 24-hour streamer. But before we have him box, I must do a big shout out to my top three supporters of the stream. That is Top Badge Smurfy. We've got Q8 and Mr. Moon. Please make sure we're favoring my top three supporters of the stream. And without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Double M to the box. And he's going to briefly introduce himself, and then he is going to go into his story of the diary of a 24-hour streamer. What happens on his journey? In just a minute, we'll find out. Please make sure you hit him up with a favorite. Double, thank you so much. Top badge, Double M, thank you so much. If you can introduce yourself and jump into your story.
My name is Double M. I am a top streamer on the Plenty of Fish platform. If you guys do not have me fave, please do me a favor and fave me. I stream sporadically whenever I feel like it, because it's my world and that's the way I like to do things. So with my further ado, I will read you my diary. It's not really a diary, it's a comic book, but it's my story. There once was a man named Trouble M. Trouble M was a streamer. Trouble M was a struggling streamer. He was not really good at it, so he had to buy support. He had to gift people in order to get people in his stream. But no matter how much he gifted people, they still didn't come. One day he decides he wants to go and join a battle royale. For what reason? We don't know. Because Trouble M don't have smoke. So he tries it anyway. He sends his blast. He writes on Instagram. He messages people. He begs people. Oh my, oh my. Can we please have some support to place in these qualifiers? Now Trouble M knew that he was a janky streamer. And nobody would support him. So he knew he had to grind. He had to grind for 24 hours. And 24 hours he did. Up until the 16th hour when he had to take a dookie. And nobody will box up. And he couldn't leave his stream unattended.
So yay! Nice dunk
for an hour. And he came back. And when he came back, he was grinding. Mysteriously, people gifted him. He was in the top 21. We still trying to figure out how. Did he gift himself? Did he diamond trade? Oh my. So, on the last hour of the contest, somebody, an evil streamer by the name of Smarty Party. Smarty Party came to Trouble M stream and said, Trouble M, we see you gifting everybody out here, but you don't gift us. And it makes sense if you gift me and another guy by the name of Nam Noi. And if you gift us, Trouble M, we will help you. We will turn your dreams into being top 10 Trouble M of all time and make it a reality. Trouble M said, no, Smarty. We're gonna do this organically. Smarty said, wrong answer, kid. And he sniped everybody else. And Trouble M fell 10K short of qualifying for the battle games. So tragic. But one thing's for sure and two things for certain was meant for you, nobody can take. And two people dropped out of the qualifier, putting Trouble M in the battle games. And Trouble M had to face Smarty Party in the first round and smoke that goofy. The end.
Clapping for yourself is crazy. Ladies and gentlemen, you didn't win yet. You didn't win yet. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're now tuning in, you're listening to Top Badge Double M give his take on the diary of a 24-hour streamer. Was it loosely based on anyone we know? Any one of the characters sounds familiar? This is all fiction. This is all fun. So in time, we'll find out. Double, thank you so much for being part of our show today. You're welcome. If you can return to the audience, and after the last storyteller have gone, the judges will then box up, give their feedback, and they will decide on a winner for today's episode. Ladies and gentlemen, are we enjoying the show? Are we enjoying some of these diary reveals? I certainly am. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you are favoriting not only my guests, but you're taking a moment to favorite my admins. It's Moody Andrew, Bariqua Queen, and Emoji J. They're right here in the audience. Please reach out to them if you'd like to be a guest. We might be pulling some people that have been in attendance today. We're probably going to be checking on some of the viewers and encourage them to be on the show. Also, a big shout out to my top three supporters of the stream. It is Top Badge Smurfy, Tickle Pickle, and Q8. Thank you to my top three. Please make sure you have the supporters favorited. And ladies and gentlemen, if you would like to be a part of our show, please message us. This is all to have fun. This is all to just bring out a little bit of your creative talents and, you know, maybe stare a few new viewers your way once they've seen what kind of content you can create. Ladies and gentlemen, I must welcome my next guest to the box. He is another top badge that is on our app. He goes by the name of Top Badge Eddie, and he is no stranger to content creation. He has his own featured show among other shows that he's involved in. So please make sure we are putting our hands together, our virtual hands that is, and welcome Top Badge Eddie to our show. And in just a moment, after he's introduced himself, he is going to go into his story of the diary of a 24-hour streamer. And I must ask the other guests that are part of the show to please box up at this time so we can have everyone in queue. Top Badge Eddie, thank you so much for being on my show. I believe this is your first
Yes, my first time here. first time being a part of the show. I'm extremely honored to be here. For those of you guys that don't know me, my name is Eddie. I do have a featured show here on the Meet Me app every single Tuesday at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So if anybody wants to be a part of that show, you can reach out to NorCal DJ Battles. I think she's here in the comments somewhere, and we can make that happen. Another big event that we do have going on, you guys, is later on today, I believe starting at 4:05 p.m. in Kitty Commander's stream. We have 37 featured show hosts that are going to be available to answer your questions and share a little bit of insight about the featured show community on the Meet Me app. So if you guys are interested in checking out some of the featured show hosts that are on the app and seeing what's going on the app, what we have going on, Mesh is a part of that. Myself is a part of that. Smurfy's a part of that. We've got a lot of featured show creators that are a part of that. I also have my Halloween auction.
Everyone is already invested, and you are not. Make a move with Octave.
Auction. You guys want to be a part of an auction? This would be a great opportunity to get involved and be a part of that. So before we start our story, Mej, I do want to say that some of these names may sound a little familiar to you. I want you to know that I have reached out to the people that I am telling the story about. They have given me full permission to make this story about them, so we're going to make it happen. So tonight's story, you guys, takes place in a stream far, far away. And I'm telling you guys, we're talking far. Not just a little bit far, but like really, really far, right? And this story consists of three top badges. We have top badge Laxie that is going to be a part of this story. Top badge Penny, the Queen of Sniping, that's a part of this story. And top badge Latin Mice, all on a journey, on a 24-hour stream with one thing in common, a contest grind. Well, one thing that you guys don't know is that Laxie and Latin Mice have been seeing each other on the side for quite a long time. The two of them decided that they were going to team up and they were going to run every contest there was as far as they could possibly run it, further than a mice could run. Latin Mice, she was all about supporting Laxie. And Laxie, so in love with Latin Mice, they decided, you know, maybe it's time that they stream together. Show their affectionate side towards one another. Show the streaming community how much they meant to each other and how much they supported each other. Laxie and Latin Mice decided that they were going to stream from Latin Mice's home that night. And they were going to do this 24-hour stream in this contest. One way or another, one of them was going to win. Didn't matter what it was going to take. They were ready to run this contest up. Well, Laxie decided that she needed a little bit of a break, so she decided to go in and take a little nap. But before she took a nap, she decided she wanted to freshen up, so she decided to go through Latin Mice's top drawer of her bedside table. Once she opened the drawer of that bedside table, what she saw brought tears to Laxie's eyes. She was so concerned. She was so devastated. She saw photos of the one and only Penny, Queen of Sniping. At this point, Latin Mice was so concerned about what Laxie had been doing on the side. She chose that she was going to go and confront her lover to find out what exactly was going on. Before Laxie had the opportunity to confront Laxie, the one and only Penny, Queen of Sniping, popped into the stream. And guys, you can imagine how that went. It was all bad, all bad. Penny comes in with one wheel. She comes in with two wheels. She comes in with the golden wheel. And Laxie says, enough is enough. Enough is enough. We need to work this out. Let's all get into the box. So they began to chat in the box. And before you realize it, Boxho joins the box. Another member of the LGBTQ community. He thought that he had his 2 cents to put in. But when Boxho arrived to the box, something happened that we never would have expected to happen. Penny, the queen of sniping, decides that she is not going to put her girlfriend, Loxy, into the contest. She decides that she's going to put her one and only friend, Boxho, into the competition. And before you realize it, it is dragon wheel after dragon wheel after dragon wheel. Penny, the queen of sniping, dropping 5 million in a box to make sure that her lover, Loxy, falls bottom of the competition. 23 hours into the stream, Boxho thinks he's doing amazing. And before we realize it, Mag decides that no. There's no way in heaven that my man is going to be sniped by some queen. So Maj loads her clip. She comes in with a bang and she drops a total of 10 milli, bringing Boxho to number 20 of all time on the leaderboards. And to this day, they all still love one another. Maj, thank you for having me, my friend.
Do they really? Sounds like a part two of this show is
sounds like work. A part two, Maj.
This definitely
Maj. let me get that straight. I am so sorry, Maj. We don't want to be calling you Maj tonight. We don't want to be calling you.
It's a Maj for me. More like magic. So. That's what it is. Magic. Ladies and gentlemen, Maj, if you're not
so
tuning in, my pleasure. Please favorite Top Badge Eddie. Thank you so much for being a part of our show. Ladies and gentlemen, please make sure that we are favoriting all of our guests. And definitely hit the star in my name. Hit me up with a favorite. Also, if you can please favorite my top three supporters of this stream. I appreciate and I love them all dearly. It is Top Badge Smurfy, Tickle Pickle, and Top Badge Double M. They're my top three. And at 4 o'clock, we are going to announce the Gold King or Queen of the stream. Now, a couple of shout outs before we get our next guest in. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're now tuning in, welcome to Once Upon a Mess Story. The theme today is the diary of a 24-hour streamer. And this is where our guests are there going to give their spin on the theme for today. And it's going to be all fanciful, a lot of fun, similar to what you've been hearing for the past 4 stories. So I hope you've been enjoying some of the familiar names, and you've been getting a good laugh out of them. This is what streaming is about, to be entertaining and to let people in to your creative content and what you're capable of producing. Thank you to all my viewers for watching. Please reach out to us. Please reach out to us if you'd like to be a guest on the show. Ladies and gentlemen, I notice it's judged, and that's why sometimes people are a little reluctant to be a part of the show. But I promise you, all of our judges are also content creators, so they know to give you constructive feedback to help you improve your stories and probably give you a couple of tips that you can use for future events or shows that you may be involved in. Our community is about encouraging and giving tips that is going to be useful for streaming. They're all three amazing judges. They're all three my friends. So we're here to help you to be even a bigger star. So please don't be discouraged to being a part of the show. Ladies and gentlemen, I must now call on my next 2 guests. If they can request the box. I know I've seen Chronic Chris in here, but he needs to request the box and not just be running up the comments. Ladies and gentlemen, we also have a special performer during the judges' deliberation. So we are going to have a little bit of some musical talent to get everyone all started. Ladies and gentlemen, I must welcome to the box. He is also a content creator. He has a show today on Saturday. He may tell you a little bit about it. He is known as Chronic Chris. And little side note, he was also one of the streamers that was on for a 24-hour stream getting into the qualifier. Did he make it in? We don't know, because he's going to give us his take on the 24-hour streamer. Chris, welcome to the show. Thank you so much for being a part of it. If you'd like to introduce yourself and then jump right into your story.
All right. Hello, everyone. I'm Chronic Chris. For those that don't know, I've been on here for 2.5 years. And yes, I do have a featured show on here as well. Saturdays today, 8 p.m. Eastern. Feel free to check us out in my stream. Name that gift. Every Saturday, 8 o'clock, we test how well the streamers on their app know the different gifts, VIP gifts, regular gifts, things like that. And yeah, Mesh asked me to be here today and tell my story of my battle qualifier push on Wednesday. And I was a little nervous, but I was honored to tell the story. And yeah, we're here to tell you guys how it happened. All right, get into it. Get right into it. All right, start with my little music. Hello, all. This is the story about a young Canadian streamer who was putting countless nights of work and effort into his content and platform over 2.5 years as a Meet Me streamer, and ultimately ends up getting put on a pedestal with some of the biggest names on the app. Yes, I'm talking about me, and I'm talking about the Meet Group Battle Games qualifiers. A nail-biting, sweat-inducing, yet for some people, easy opportunity that only comes twice a year, and like the lottery, results in a spotlit moment for 32 lucky streamers. Did I ever think I'd be one of them? Hell no. Since starting on the app back in March 2021, when it took me a whole 4 months just to hit that first milli, never in my life did I think I would see myself where I am today. The 58 million diamonds and 15K faves have been such a blessing, but the app has also brought out a creative and social side of me I didn't even know I had. It has shown me that I'm capable of hosting amazing events and doing graphic designs I didn't even know I could do. It has given me connections and real life friends that I've even taken trips to see. It has given me a featured show 1 hour per week where I get to channel my creativity while educating the live community on the gifts we have. And through it all, Top Badge has been in the back of my mind, but I've never pushed for it heavily. I am a believer of if something is meant to happen, it will happen. And speaking on that note, that brings me back to the Battle Games qualifiers. 2.5 years on this app, almost 1,000 days, and I've only ever missed one day of streaming. As much as I love streaming though, surprisingly enough, I've only done a 24-hour stream once before, and that was for the Spring 2023 Battle Games qualifiers. Back in March of this year, when the app first announced the qualifier for the Spring Games, I felt I had pretty decent support, and after talking to some of my people, I decided I was going to try for it. And after 24 tiresome hours and a stressful final minute push, we ended up number 39 and only fell 50K short of placing in the Spring Battle Games. Having put in so much work into my 10 past Battle Royales, I was definitely a little disappointed I didn't qualify, but I knew right then and there that just like Top Badge, it wasn't my time yet. Going for the Fall Battle Games was always in the back of my mind since that day, but I didn't even know if it was going to happen. But I knew if it did happen, I had to try again. I owed it to myself and my people that pushed me in the last one. So I avoided doing any events all summer, just in case this opportunity presented itself to me. And sure enough, September rolls around and the Fall Battle Games have been announced. I didn't know if I had the same support as the last qualifier, especially considering I had just done Top Badge Winda's Casino Royale last month. Nonetheless, I did the exact same thing I did last time. I made a flyer to promote my goal and posted and sent it to my supporters. I even put it in my stream descriptions all week. As I always say, if you want something bad enough, you gotta promote it and let it be known what your goal is. All that was left to do was wait. Wednesday had come around and I got on live right at midnight. And by 3 a.m. we were only 6K into the push. I knew it was early, so I didn't get discouraged. Instead, I decided I was going to, don't judge me, keep my stream running and take a nap, hoping that maybe in a few hours something would have changed. Side note, I do not condone sleep streams on the regular, but this was different, okay? To my surprise, I had woken up to 50K in wheels from my number two gifter and 10K from others, and I was already number 40 in the qualifiers. It was time to grind. I stayed on all day and had multiple amazing people coming in throwing wheels to help support my cause. Unfortunately, my Wi-Fi crashed around 3 p.m. and my stream ended while being number 36. Still determined, I got right back on, and my dear friend Fleming came in throwing mad wheels, hitting a Golden Castle bonus, snatching a point, and pushing me to number 32. We were in for now. My number two heartbreaker returned shortly after and decided 32 wasn't good enough, so she spun and spun until I hit top 25. I was ecstatic. Hours went by, people popped in, and wheels spun some more. Nary a bonus in sight, but yet we were maintaining top 32. Before I knew it, we were down to the final hours. Heartbreaker returns again, yet throwing a boss jet and boss knight to snatch my 58 milli amongst all the wheels. I was just in awe at how much my numbers had moved since midnight. I had people whose board I wasn't even on helping me out. Before I knew it, the last 10 minutes had came and I was sweating like crazy. This was it, the moment I had been waiting for. I had five amazing people come back with wheels to help me at the snipe when I had thought I would have nobody. We saw a few small bonuses, some golden buzzers and pegasuses, as the clock counted down the last 10 seconds. We all crossed our fingers and boom, it had ended. Midnight came, and to my surprise, not only did we place, but we finished number 22 with 638K. I refused to believe it was true, but my people reassured me I was not seeing things. We celebrated in my stream, then I went to sleep early that night after achieving my biggest streaming accomplishment to date. This is a perfect example of when it's your time, you will know. Patience is key and everyone's moment is loading. I've already won just by placing in these games alongside 31 of the biggest names out of a whole community, and I'm excited to see what other blessings are awaiting me in round one on the 27th. I hope you'd join me on the next part of this journey to see how my story ends. That is my 24-hour stream story. Thank you.
Good job, ladies and gentlemen. If you're now tuning in, you're just listening to Chronic Chris give his take on the diary of a 24-hour streamer. Thank you so much, Chris, and good luck in the battle.
I started
game.
Writing that half an hour before the show, so thank you. I hope I didn't do too bad.
thank you, everybody.
I appreciate y'all.
Thank you. All right, in just a moment, after our last guest, our judges will then box up and give their feedback on today's guest. All the stories were really good. I think it's gonna make for quite an interesting discussion among the judges. Ladies and gentlemen, before I introduce our last guest for today, a quick shout out. Please make sure you're favoring my top three. Some events happening on the across the app. There's a featured show extravaganza being hosted by Kitty Commander starting at 4 o'clock. Please make sure everyone has Kitty Commander favorited so you get a chance to see all the amazing shows that are here on the app. I'm going to be in there as well, so please make sure that you're tuned in. Ladies and gentlemen, I must introduce my next guest. He's no stranger to the streaming platform. He goes by the name of Charm Charlie, and he's going to briefly introduce himself, and then he's going to jump into his take of the diary of a 24-hour streamer. Charlie, welcome, welcome. Thank you so much for being on the show. Please go ahead and introduce yourself.
Hi, everybody. I'm Charm Charlie. You can also just call me Charlie, and I'm a disability advocate on the app, and I actually have my own featured show called You've Got a Friend with Charm Charlie, and we talk about overcoming adversity and life challenges. And today is the Hoops is hosting a auction for everyone and it has a disability. And that's it. Mine's at 8:10. And then also at 5 p.m., I forgot, is the featured show extravaganza. I'm super excited about that. So let me go on to read my story now. Okay, awesome. Hi, everybody. So I wrote in my diary today. And today I wrote in my diary about when I streamed for 24 hours. So it says, one day I woke up and said, hey, I'm going to do a 24-hour stream. I thought I was crazy, but it was fun. That day, I thought I would start a diary. And here it goes. It read, dear diary, I decided to go live for 24 hours. At first, I was saying this is a crazy idea. The first 30 minutes were really slow. I thought to myself, why is it really slow? And I was like, maybe it's because I was telling all my dumb dad jokes that I had. And my favorite joke that I told that day was, how do you sing a country song backwards? Well, you get your truck back, you get your wife back, and you get your dog back. That was my favorite joke of that stream that day. But the hardest part of the day was every single wheel that I got during that 24-hour stream, I had to make an animal sound. An animal sound that I decided to make was a horse sound. And it went like this. And everyone thought, what was that? What did I just hear? Was that a Charlie horse that I just heard? And then, guys, and then at 15 hours into this, I got really tired. And so I started listening to Bodies by Drowning Pool. You guys know the song? Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Yep. And that is the song. And I was awake the rest of the stream. And then I opened the date box, guys. And the date box was so much fun. All the ladies were coming in there and they were spitting their game. But my favorite pickup line someone gave me was, I think my Spotify's broken because you're not in my today's hottest singles. And then by 24 hours, I was so tired, but I got my goal and I survived my 24-hour stream. And I told myself, I don't think that I am ever going to do a 24-hour stream again. And thank you guys for listening to my story.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're now tuning in, you were just listening to Charm Charlie give his account of the diary of a 24-hour streamer. Which one of these amazing guests is going to take home the championship title today? In just a moment, we will find out. Charlie, thank you so much for being a part of the show.
Thank you for having me.
Right back in the audience. And please, everyone, please make sure you hit him up with a favorite. He does have a bunch of content in his streams. Please make sure you're popping in and saying hello. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are in for a special, special treat. Just before the judges pop up, we are going to be listening to the beautiful Maris Paris. And she is going to give her special performance of Angel Is Mine. Ladies and gentlemen, please make sure you're hitting up with our favorite. Maris, if you'd like to introduce yourself and jump right into your song. Ladies and gentlemen, please make sure you have her favorited. She's absolutely amazing.
Hi guys, it's nice to be here. My name is Maris and I'm a Nigerian and a member of GTR. I hope that you enjoy this song titled Angel of Mine by Monica.
Inside of you, something I thought that I would never find, angel of mine. I look at you, looking at me. Now I know why they say the best things are free. I'm gonna love you, boy, you are so fine. Angel of mine. How you change my world, you'll never know. I'm different now, you help me to grow. you came into my life, sent from above. When I lost all hope, you showed me love. I'm searching for you, boy, you were right on time. Angel of mine, nothing means more to me than what we share. No one in this world can ever compare. Last night the way you moved is still on my mind. Angel of mine, what you mean to me you never know. Deep inside I need to show. You came into my life, sent from above. When I lost all hope, you showed me love. I'm checking for you, boy, you were right on time. Angel of mine, I never knew I could feel it. Moment as if they were new. Every breath that I take is the love that we make. I only share it with you. You. When I first saw you, I already knew there was something inside of you. Something I thought that I would never find. Angel of mine. Oh, angel of mine.
Ladies and gentlemen, the beautiful Maris Paris. Please make sure you hit her up with a favorite. Show her some love. Jump by her stream. She is new to the app and she's full of beautiful, beautiful, beautiful music inside of her. We wanted to get out there. Thank you so much for being a part of my show, Maris. I appreciate you. Please love on her. Judges, please box up at as Maris is finishing up. Judges, I'm going to ask that you please, please, please box up. All right. Whenever they're ready. Guys, make sure you hit up Maris with a favorite. Ooh, get that love in there. Yes. Show some love. Please, please.